Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. the Honorable Keith Christopher Rowley. Please remain standing for our national anthem performed on Pan by Johansson Clark. Thank you, Johansson. I now call on Reverend Dr. Benjamin Agard, Senior Pastor, Church of the Rock, to offer our opening prayer. And please remain standing as he will be followed by Archbishop Wayne Jones of the St. Francis Spiritual Baptist Church.
Father, we give you thanks and praise this evening for this time together. Lord, this community has been blessed to have this facility to help our young people and even others. Thank you for the investment being made today to ensure, God, that the lives of people would be changed. Father, we pray that those who would use this facility would appreciate the effort and the sacrifices that were made to have it available in this community. And, oh God, may we provide the care and may we provide, oh God, the support for our young people as they rise to excellence. Thank you, oh God, for our those in authority. Thank you for the MPs and thank you for the government and the powers that be that has chosen this place so, God, we can use it for your honor and your glory. Father, we give you praise and thanks. May we have the same success, oh God, as this pool with the coronavirus. Give our leaders wisdom and strength so we too, God, can conquer even this virus. Thank you, Father. Bless us today together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Eternal God, giver of all life and sojourner of all things, as we come before your presence this hour, O God, we ask for your guidance and your protection. Father, as we assemble on this spot, we pray, God, that you would sanctify it, and that, O God, that you would place your angels on every corner of this compound. May it be used for the benefit of this community, O God. Father, we ask you to guide and protect us, those in authority. Pray, God, a blessing shall fall upon them. But most of all this evening, O God, we thank you for this wonderful community of Mova. And I pray, God, that the blessing of Almighty God would be upon this community, this pool, this area, and all that dwell therein. This we ask in Jesus' almighty name. Amen and amen.
Thank you very much. We may now be seated. Dr. the Honorable Keith Rowley, Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. The Honorable Fitzgerald Hines, Minister of National Security. The Honorable Shamfaka Joe, Minister of Sport and Community Development. The Honorable Adrian Leonce, Minister in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Development and Member of Parliament for Lavantil East, Morvant. Brigadier General Dexter Francis, Acting CDS. Lieutenant Commander Alden Jasper, Acting Commanding Officer, Coast Guard. Captain Douglas Archer, Commanding Officer, Defense Force Reserves. Aldermen and Councillors of the San Juan Lavantil Regional Corporation. Ms. Angela Edwards, Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Sport and Community Development. Mr. Noel Garcia, Chairman, UDICOT. Ms. Tamika Charles Phillips, CEO of UDICOT. Management and staff of UDICOT. Reverend Dr. Benjamin Agard, Senior Pastor, Church of the Rock. Archbishop Wayne Jones, St. Francis Spiritual Baptist Church. Members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the official opening ceremony for the Morvant Community Swimming Pool. I'm your Master of Ceremonies, Marc-André Augustus. Without delay, I now call on the Honorable Adrian Leonce, Minister in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Development and Member of Parliament for Lavantil East Morvant, to deliver the opening remarks.
Good afternoon, Honorable Prime Minister, Honorable Fitzgerald Hines, the members of the Protective Services, the executives of UDICOT, Ministry of Sport, my beautiful community, people that keep us alive, the spiritual leaders in our community, the media, welcome. I welcome you to, if not the most beautiful place, the most beautiful place. This place that we call Morvant, that the Prime Minister always boasts about, that he spent some bit of his growing years, and I would dare to say it is his most important years in Morvant. I would like to just congratulate the people of Morvant for delivering such a beautiful facility. The facility was built by the hands of the residents of this community, and I want to congratulate them for that. I'd also like to thank my Honorable Prime Minister and the executives of UDICOT for understanding that even small contractors within our community can build great facilities like this, transformational facilities like this. And we look forward to this to continue. The pool, to me, is a birthing place, a place of opportunities, a place where almost every sport could partake in terms of therapy and training, a place for development in skills, a place where we can see a bright future, a place where we could come together, a place where we can think. I see this pool as a transformational facility of this community. I remember in primary school seeing other children going and walking to a community pool, and knowing that the children of Morvant didn't have that, I look forward to this happening now. I want to say that within all these efforts that are being made, I would like to call on the right-thinking, upstanding citizens of my community to say a prayer against this spirit of violence that seemed to be trying to lift its head again in our community. We have to face these things. We have to make some changes, and we have to be stern. We have to be stern in what we say and what we do. So when we see the spirit of violence probably encompassing a young man or a young woman, let us embrace them. Let the church leaders embrace them. Let us come out of the walls of the churches and enter the streets where they sit, where they hang out. Let us embrace them and let the spirit of violence know it's not welcome. Let the spirit of violence know it's not welcome. Also, let us understand that we're in a different time. A time where today you're with someone and tomorrow they're not here. I was going through my Facebook feed and every pity I saw was almost RIP, sleep in peace. And it's a terrifying thing. And the government is doing all that they can to protect and save the lives of this citizenry. And we as individuals have to do what we can too. We have to be responsible. So for us to fully enjoy this great facility and to see our children, our elders, and the rest of the community enjoying it in the fullness, we have to win this war against the virus. So let us fight together against the virus, against crime, against criminality. And let us enjoy this beautiful place called Mova. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minister Leonce. I have a correction to make. Of course, it's Commander Alden Jasper, Acting Commanding Officer of the Coast Guard. I now invite to the podium the Honorable Fitzgerald Hines, Minister of National Security, to bring us his welcoming remarks.
Thank you very warmly, Mr. Master of Ceremonies, for your welcome and your kind introduction. Dr. The Honorable Keith Rowley, Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. In her absence, the Honorable Shamfa Kodjo, Minister of Sport and Community Development. The Honorable Adrian Leonce, my parliamentary and ministerial colleague, the Member of Parliament for Lavantel East Mova, where this edifice sits, Brigadier General Dexter Francis, Acting Chief of Defense Staff of the Trinidad and Tobago Defense Force, Commander Alden Jasper, Acting Commander of the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard, Captain Douglas Archer, Commanding Officer of the Defense Force Reserve, Aldermen, Councillors of the Sanwa-Lavantel Regional Corporation, Ms. Angela Edwards, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Sport and Community Development, other officials of that ministry, Mr. Noel Garcia, the very hard-working and forward-thinking chairman of UDCOT, and other officials of UDCOT, in particular, Madam Tamika Charles, its CEO, Reverend Benjamin, Dr. Benjamin Agard, senior pastor of the very well-known Church on the Rock, Archbishop Wayne Jones, well-known of the St. Francois Spiritual Baptist Church, members of the media, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in particular, the residents of the community of Coconut Drive in Mova and environs who would benefit directly from what is on offer here today. The opportunity and pleasure is indeed mine to specially welcome the Honorable Prime Minister, the Member of Parliament for Dago Martin West, to Mova, to Lavantil, once again. Many talk about this man in ways they know not. I have heard many people say that this Prime Minister is only concerned about the rich and posh areas, so-called, in Trinidad and Tobago, and the hoi polloi, and the so-called derogatory term of the 1%, a term that I reject and never use, because we are all nationals of Trinidad and Tobago, all of us. But I welcome the Honorable Prime Minister to our community again. And I am able to bear testimony to the fact that this must be the 10th or 11th occasion that he has come for various reasons to our community. In addition to that, for those who have the benefit of working directly with the Honorable Prime Minister, and for those who would have worked with him through the many years, we know and can bear testimony to the commitment of this national leader to the people of our communities, including the community of Lavantil. So I specially welcome you, Prime Minister, on this occasion yet again. When we last met at a pool, it was at Sogrin Trace in my constituency in Lavantil. Let me pause to welcome now the Honorable Shamfa Kodjo. Honorable Minister, welcome. We were around the poolside at Sogrin Trace, celebrating that great achievement and its potential. And the Prime Minister said to us that if this thing is so good, we must do it again, and we must do it in Mova, an area that he had great familiarity with, as Mr. Leons told us. He spent many of his youthful days right here in Coconut Drive and environs. And indeed, Prime Minister, Sogrin Trace is a tremendous success. It is with great pride that I saw youngsters 10 years and younger doing two lengths of that pool comfortably, they having come from a non-swimming or a non-pool in their community background and experience. I saw that. I saw senior citizens enjoying their moments in that pool at Sogrin Trace in Lavantil, engaging in what they call water therapy, working in unison, and enjoying it thoroughly. A great success it was. So today, we do the same here in Coconut Drive in Mova. I looked around at this place, beautiful trees standing proudly around on the perimeter. I look at the football field, one known to all the residents. I look at the pool. And of course, during its construction, I drove past and would stop sometimes on the hill and look down on it. And I'll call Mr. Garcia, I'll call the architect, I'll call the contractor, young Kareem Marcel, and I would ask, when is this going to be finished? And I didn't ask it on my own volition always. Every Minister Kodjo will know, every Thursday, when we gather together to look after the nation's business in the cabinet, somewhere along the line, the Prime Minister would call, not on me, you know. Now, Mr. Hines, what about that pool? And I would tell him it was 50% done, it was 65% done, and I took him through the process. Today, it is done. It is finished. and it is ready to be presented to the people for their use and benefit here in Coconut Drive. All of this, Prime Minister, was only possible largely because of the contribution, and I speak as Minister of National Security now, I wasn't then, but largely on account of the contribution of the work of the Trinidad and Tobago Defense Force, more particularly the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard, led today by Commander Jasper. Because when you called on them, and it was your call, because of you understood the sociology, the geography, and the potential for this space at Sogrin Trace at that time, and for this, as you bequeathed it, you asked that the Coast Guard be involved in that project, because you knew that the maker of all steel bands, Desperados, a band that you supported along with others, of course, from the West, but you knew from the reports available to you that the Great Despers had to leave its home turf and take up residence elsewhere. And I recall on one occasion when Desperados was practicing on Cadiz Road away from their natural habitat and home, there was an attack involving the use of firearms at that place, showing total disregard for life and limb and total disregard for the greatness and what Desperados represented to Laventille, to Trinidad and Tobago, to all of us. We knew that there are citizens who are capable of that kind of behavior, and I have a suspicion that it was with concepts such as those, much as he knew the people will appreciate this and value it, and the large majority of us will benefit from it. Happily, there are elements in this country and in our community who will turn the table upside down and tarnish that potential and that peace and the development that this portends. And so you ask, Prime Minister, that the Coast Guard be engaged. Well, along with the security that they bring discipline to those who they had the responsibility to nurture and to train. They brought professional training. All of the officers of the Coast Guard who lined the walkway for you as you arrived, Prime Minister, are specialists, instructors in the business of swimming and saving lives and all that the Coast Guard does. And the Coast Guard, in the midst of this pandemic, along with the larger formations of the Defense Force, makes a serious contribution to a national response in terms of COVID-19 and its variants. But inside of all of that, they took the time and they take the time to give of themselves to the youngsters as they have been doing. These children have prospered beautifully. Wendy Rock called me one day to tell me that the children had been calling on the officers of the Coast Guard, and that's why I use the word nurturing. It went more than training, Prime Minister. They became like parents and friends to the youngsters, and there were occasions when there were no schedules for class, but the children of Sogrin Trace would come in and talk to the Coast Guard officers, wanting them to be mentors, to be big brothers, to be fathers, asking them for refreshments and other such things, and they began to develop a close relationship with the community. So I would like to take the opportunity to thank you for your vision in that regard, Prime Minister, and of course, to thank and to congratulate the Chief of Defense Staff, through you, Brigadier General Francis, acting as you are today, and all of the elements, all of the members of the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard in particular, for your contribution in this work. It falls to me to thank the people of this community, as Mr. Leon did, and the contractor for staying steadfast to the contract and getting it done, and to thank in particular the people of the community who cooperated. It did not go without its hiccups. I was closely involved, Prime Minister, so I know that there were hiccups along the way, as is to be expected. But by and large, the thing was done. It was done effectively, and today we are. So thank you very much, Prime Minister. Thank you all. And long live the people of this community, and I pray that it would bring benefit and growth and development to them and generate national and international swimmers as part of the outflow from this wonderful thought as introduced by the Honorable Prime Minister. I thank you.
Thank you, Minister Hines. I now invite to the podium the Honorable Shamfaka Joe, Minister of Sport and Community Development, to bring us her remarks on this auspicious occasion.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. A hearty good evening, good afternoon to one and all. I want to recognize all Prime Minister Dr. the Honorable Keith Christopher Rowley, my colleague, Mr. Fitzgerald Hines, Minister of National Security, Ms. Honorable Adrian Leon, Member of Parliament for Lavantil East Mova, Minister in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Development, Brigadier General Dexter Francis, Lieutenant Commander Alden Jasper, Captain Douglas Archer, Aldermen, Councillors of the Sanwal Lavantil Regional Corporation, members of staff from the Ministry of Sport and Community Development, Mr. Noel Garcia, Chairman of UDICUT, the other members and representatives from UDICUT here in our presence today, Reverend Dr. Benjamin, Senior Pastor, Church of the Rock, Archbishop Wayne Jones, St. Francis Spiritual Baptist Church, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's a pleasure for me to be here this afternoon to share the opening of the much-anticipated Mova Community Swimming Pool. May I say public community swimming pool. It was Nelson Mandela who said that sport has the power to change the world. It has the power to inspire. It has the power to unite in a way like little else does. It speaks to youth in a language that they understand. Sport can create hope where there once was despair. Sport is more than making regional championships, international championships, the world championships, Olympics, getting medals, and so on. For us, sport is about improving the lot for people within the community or young people throughout Trinidad and Tobago. Today we celebrate sport as a vehicle for social development, for community empowerment, and a force for positive change. Today's ceremony signifies the government's commitment to developing communities through sport, to investing in our young people, and to expand economic activity at the community level throughout Trinidad and Tobago. As Minister of Sport and Community Development, I am excited because we are adding today one more public community swimming pool to our inventory. There are seven others, and this is the eighth community swimming pool. There are countries that cannot speak about having one public community swimming pool. In Trinidad and Tobago today, we speak of eight swimming pools. And even as we speak right now, there's another swimming pool being developed in the community of Maloney. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's all about utilizing sport to develop our young people and to encourage and to empower the people throughout our communities. It's not just about winning medals. It's about changing lives and creating opportunities. I've met Mr. Nicholas Paul, our world-renowned cyclist. And Nicholas was once a young footballer who got injured. It could have been the end of his sporting career for Nicholas, but he decided he's going to try cycling in the street. and then got involved in the group and then started cycling at our cycling velodrome. Based on the performances of cyclists like Nicholas Paul in Trinidad and Tobago and his performance on the world stage, we are now working with UCI to develop our national cycling velodrome into an international development center for cycling, the only one of its kind in the Americas. And that is the type of work, the type of investment that this government is focused on. And we have been developing facilities throughout Trinidad and Tobago, not just in the town or in the centers, but also in the communities. We speak to the new facility that was built at Maruga and recently built at Mahaika. And here we are today in Mova. Ladies and gentlemen, in January, Trinidad and Tobago would host the ICC Under 19 World Championship. We are going to be the place to be in January for cricketers, young cricketers throughout the world. And that is all because we built a world-class facility in the Diggle Martin community. And that is what this type of investment is all about. It's not just about the development of the athlete, but preparing our people to serve the rest of Trinidad and Tobago, to serve as a sporting hub, to promote sport, tourism, and activities so that we can learn and we can grow as a people, not just developing more athletes, but expanding economic opportunity for the people of Trinidad and Tobago. I am excited, almost as excited as the Prime Minister. I don't think anybody here could be as excited as he is, as he has been following up on this project for as long as I can remember. It is not just about adding a new facility to the inventory, but it's seeing the work that the Trinidad and Tobago Defense Force and the Coast Guard has been doing at Sogrin Trace. We at the Ministry of Sport and Community Development, we maintain the facility, but it is the gentlemen of the TTDF that do the work. This is where young people from that community come to get a meal, and they look up to these men as teachers, as role models, even as father figures. And this is the type of impact that sport has on communities, on people. As Nelson Mandela said, it does what little else can do. Yes? So today we celebrate sport, its transformative power, its ability to unify our communities, to transform the lives of the young people, and to create opportunities for Trinidadians and Tobagonians, not just here, but also abroad. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to salute UDCOT for working hand in hand with the Ministry of Sport and Community Development and with the government as we travel from community to community, improving the lot for the people of Trinidad and Tobago. To the people of Mova, how do I say this nicely? We always want, everybody wants a swimming pool. Everybody wants a playing field. Everybody wants a stadium. But it's our responsibility to develop activity, to utilize these facilities, and to protect them, to preserve them. At the end of the day, this facility belongs to you. I've seen way too often going out, looking at facilities, doing the little checkups and so on, and there are people literally ripping seats out of stadium. We cannot have that kind of behavior. We have to take full responsibility for our communities and for our country. So I want to encourage you, this is your swimming pool, an investment made by the government of Trinidad and Tobago. And we are going to continue to invest in you. But there are some things that you must do for yourselves. Yes? So I ask you to protect, to preserve, to keep your community clean, and to secure this facility, this world-class facility. Mova, you're the envy of a number of communities throughout Trinidad and Tobago, because there are others saying, why Mova? Why not me? So today, I really want to celebrate with you, and I expect to see good things coming out of this swimming pool, not just the athletes, but also a building generational relationship between the elders and the younger men, teaching them how to swim, teaching them how to be better young men, bringing other communities to your facility for meets and so on. The opportunities are endless. So I am pleased to be here with you today, and I want to encourage you to make the very best of it. This is yours. This is your swimming pool. This is your community. Make the very best of it. And we as government, we are going to continue to facilitate, to invest, to improve your lives. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you. God bless you. God bless our nation. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Kajo. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to welcome Miss Candace Caton, who will give us our entertainment feature today, and she's going to do a number called I Was Here. She's going to introduce it for you.
Good afternoon. Hello. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me? Mic check. There we go. Good afternoon, everyone. As someone who has lived in Rowley for all of my life, I am absolutely thrilled to be singing at this opening ceremony today. And I just want to echo the sentiments of both Minister Nyant and Minister Kuchu in saying that, you know, time is short. We don't know how long we have left. I want to encourage each and every one of us to make the best of the time that we have on this day.
I always
was here. I was here. I was here. I was here.
Thank you, Candace. Ladies and gentlemen, kindly welcome to the lectern the Honorable Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. Keith Rowley, to deliver the feature address.
Thank you very much, our master of ceremonies today. Please permit me to acknowledge my cabinet colleagues, the Honorable Fitzgerald Hines, Member of Parliament for Lavantil West, serving as Minister of National Security, my other cabinet colleague, Member of Parliament for Tobago West, serving as Minister of Sport and Community Development, the Honourable Adrian Lyons, Member of Parliament for Lavantil East Morvant, serving in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Development. And permit me to make a very special acknowledgement to a group of people led by Brigadier General Dexter Francis, who is acting as Commander, Chief of Defence Staff. Commander Alden Spencer, Acting Commanding Officer of the Coast Guard, Captain Douglas Archer, Commanding Officer of the Defence Force Reserves, and of course, those who have offered themselves for public office, our aldermen, our councillors from the Samoan Lavantil Regional Corporation. And in the Ministry, I'd like to acknowledge Ms. Angela Edwards, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Sport and Community Development, and those who build and are guided by the project management team at UDCOT, led by the chairman, Mr. Noel Garcia, and acknowledge his team of professionals, Ms. Tamika Charles Phillips, in her post as CEO of UDCOT, the management and staff of UDCOT, and those who prayed with us today and prayed for us today, the Reverend Dr. Benjamin Agard, Senior Pastor, Church of the Rock, Archbishop Wayne Jones of the St. Francis Spiritual Baptist Church, the contractor, staff, and all the skilled trades that were deployed to the site, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, particularly those of you from the Morvan and neighboring communities present at this short but significant ceremony here today. Coming here to Mova this evening, I was so elated that I wanted to be so much at home in my home environment that I was tempted to dress the way I normally would dress when I live in Mova. But I couldn't find a pair of rubber slippers. I couldn't find my brown corduroy pants, and I couldn't find my Despers t-shirt. So I did the next best thing that was available at this time. So if you want to join me in being as happy as I am, you're welcome. This is for me a very, very special day and a very special occasion. Because what we are doing here today, ladies and gentlemen, is starting a process of development, and nobody knows what the future holds, except that we always say that the words of our national anthem appeal to us, and the phrases boundless faith in our destiny. That tells us that we have a future, and we have faith in that future. And even in the worst days of a pandemic which does not seem to want to be shaken off, we are here today in Morvant receiving from a contractor a very fine output for a public expenditure which we know should and would develop a section of the population, and I dare say the national population of Trinidad and Tobago. On these occasions when we make these facilities available, I try to appeal to those who receive them as part of their community development to accept them, to receive them as the gift of the rest of the nation, because it's public money that could have been spent on something else, on other people. But on this occasion, it was spent on you. And the least we can expect of you is to be grateful that you were in receipt of these facilities at this time, and that you promise us that you would maximize the use for your benefit and for the benefit of the rest of us. Ladies and gentlemen, these pools are adding another dimension to physical activity and mental activity and sport, and I hope competition along the way, because that competition is what drives the spirit, the human soul, to try to reach the highest peak that you can reach. Many of our people in sport and other endeavors who reach to heights that they themselves never knew they had the capacity to reach, they did so because they got themselves in a competitive environment, and having to compete, they themselves discovered that they had it within them to be not just community best, national best, but world class. Ladies and gentlemen, we accept this pool from a contractor. Unfortunately, I haven't seen the name of the contractor on the profile. I guess it must be a contractor who is so Morvant, so Laventil, so humble that you just want to be one of them, one of us. But ladies and gentlemen, there's a government policy at work here. And that policy goes back to a previous administration led by Mr. Patrick Manning. And that policy is that the government, being a major driver of the national economy, especially with respect to contracts in infrastructure development in the National Development Program, that we make a very special effort to ensure that 10% of government contracts is directed to small contractors. And we do that knowing that if these contractors are given the opportunity, on more cases than not, they will be able to demonstrate that within their capacity, they can produce, and more importantly, they can grow. Because I'm sure when you realize that this was done by a small contractor, maybe the next contract that this contractor may engage in is something a little more challenging, and then one day they could point to the fact that they started out building a pool in Morvant, and the country and the community accepted what they had done, and they grew from one size to another. It's very important that we preserve that arrangement so that those who are struggling to demonstrate their skills in the construction and other areas, that opportunity that they will have could be the difference, not just between success and failure, but between life and death of the endeavor and the enterprise. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take the opportunity today to give thanks to those who have been involved in this project, at the ministry, at UDCOT, and more importantly, to our men and women in uniform at the Coast Guard and the Defense Force in general, who have agreed under the guidance of their senior officers, to make that contribution of bringing to this community of Mova, as they have brought to Laventil, as they have brought to Trinidad and Tobago, that discipline that is so much missing in so many of our communities, but which is an integral part of their everyday existence. I want to say to those people in the uniform departments of state that the uniform you wear and the discipline you demonstrate, it goes a long way to a child gazing on you or listening to you, simply saying hello to them and saying to them, good work, well done. In these pools, they will come alongside sometimes their parents, hopefully, or their uncles, their aunts, or even their older siblings. They all can find a space in this pool, and must, because we want it to be utilized. But we want it to be utilized in the environment of purpose, where that purpose is to instill in them the ambition to be great, but to do so, that discipline is an ingredient that cannot be a stranger in these parts. I would be less than open if I don't tell you that I'm a little bit nervous about handing this facility into my old home community. Because so many days the news coming from these communities is not good news, because some person or persons have misbehaved. I want today to appeal to everybody who will know that there's a pool here and that people are gathered here for the purpose of using this pool, especially the young men who arm themselves to conduct the business of criminal activity. I want to appeal to you all to understand that there's so much riding on this pool that your criminal activity could put an end to it and to the dream that we dreamt when we set about to build this pool. I want to ask all of you to let discipline be the lifeblood of whatever goes on here, and that it never be a place where there's any criminal activity which will attract national attention or make the national news. On the contrary, I want you to receive this facility in the full knowledge that in this small nation of 1.4 million people, we have produced Hazley Crawford, the Olympic gold medalist, training in San Fernando. We have produced Dwight York, whose name was the name that was shouted at the FA Cup final in England when Aston Villa got there. And when Manchester United got there, it was Dwight York from Trinidad and Tobago, from Canaan and Tobago. We would know that it was Wendell Muttley at the Tokyo Olympics who was an outstanding athlete. We would know that it was George Bovell who at the Olympics in the water got Trinidad and Tobago's name mentioned. And we still have athletes today all around the world performing from a little nation with a handful of people. When you look at us in the world, we are punching well above our weight. I don't know who is going to go into this pool, but I do know that Morva has the potential to put some child in this pool who, if our dreams come true, and if what we have put into it, we continue to put into it, that sometimes, somehow, a national swimmer will come out of this pool. And that national swimmer will go to the CC camp. And eventually one day will be on a podium representing Trinidad and Tobago. And somebody will remind us all that he or she started in the pool in Morva. And the work that our uniformed officers are volunteering to do with them, that is the seed that we will plant. And they will be the fertilizer and the care that will bring about that outcome, that the potential is there. I ask the parents and the grandparents and the guardians to help them and to help the young ones who will come in. Be a part of it, because I know the day it happens, you will be out front cheering. And I want that chair to be a chair saying, I had a hand in that. Morva, you're a community. You're producing a lot of young people. Some of them could turn out to be world-class. You don't know until they get in this pool and they subject themselves to what the Coast Guard and the Defense Force will encourage them to do. From time to time, there's a recruitment process in the Defense Force. I have no doubt that these officers will see talent. They will see attitude. They will see potential. And one or two of them will move from this pool into the Coast Guard from time to time. And I'm not just here talking about the men, because you know in Trinidad and Tobago, our door is wide open. It is our men and it is our women, and we should be very proud of that, because there are many countries which have not reached that stage yet. We've been there since 1962. So ladies and gentlemen, these facilities come to the communities not earlier than they have come. You may have wished them for quite some time, but we console ourselves by saying nothing happened before its time. Moreover, this is your time. But even though it's a very difficult period, because economically, money is not as easily available as it might have been at an earlier time, we have other distractions, but in this pandemic, we did not deny Morva the opportunity to get its swimming pool when your term came. So, as we are making these facilities available, I expect that there are times when our seniors will come out and use it, and they go home, and there are times when the youngsters, full of energy, bright-eyed and soaked, they will come. I look forward to when you begin to have competitions between the various pool environments. And that competition is when we will know that we are on our way in lighting that spark into a flame that others will notice. And the Defense Force and its volunteers and its trained people, the Coast Guard trained people, we are relying on you to extract the talent that is latent in the community of Morva and other communities which are receiving these facilities. I know guarding our borders, keeping us safe from those who will come and harm us, is a full-time job. But I don't want you to diminish this component of your assignment, whatever time you spend doing it, whether you do it by assigning people from down at Stobles Bay or being here in person. This is a major additional contribution of the Coast Guard. And if you keep doing that, your value to the nation is only growing stronger. And you yourself will know personally and feel that satisfaction of helping to develop this nation. I know some members of the Defense Force who would have wanted to help, because very many times, because of the job I have, some people come to me and say, I want to help in Laventille, I want to help in Morva, but I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do it. I don't know who to talk to. This is a program that can attract that potential. People who organize sport are as important as the people who play the sport. And if you don't believe that, look back at the time when we were, in fact, world-class in some sport, but today we are not. And you may find that one of the reasons why we have lost our place is because the sport management had not kept pace with the exposure of the talent. And whether it is West Indies cricket, Trinidad and Tobago is netball, or swimming, or whatever, the managers of the sport, the organizers of the competition, and the fans, they make it happen. So you have to work with other people. And if there's assistance to come, as there is assistance, because we are not without some resources. It is how we use the resources we have. I always remember my father saying to us, raising six boys, it's not what you work for, it's what you do with it. And I want to say to the nation, is not how many millions we can speak about, is what we do with it. And today, whatever this costs, we have done well with that allocation, but it's the start of a process. So Mova, I feel very happy to have come home to you, but I want to look forward to coming back here on very many occasions to see this pool being used for community competition, as I look forward to going to the other pools elsewhere and to the National Center. And of course, to look forward to seeing our brightest and our best representing us coming from these communities where there's always hope and that vision to be better and to be the best. So once again, I want to thank all of you who had a hand in this. We can, on the list of things to do, we can tick off Laventil. I know there's one member of the cabinet now who can come on a Thursday and not expect to be asked questions he can't answer. We can tick off Mova as we look forward to ticking off the others, because very soon we will go to Maloney to do the same thing in Maloney. And we expect that we'll add to the infrastructure for the country, because we are developing communities. So we have a very large community out there in La Hoqueta waiting for an offer like this, and of course in Chaguanas and in Point Fortin. But we have to make full use of the facilities after we build them. And that is why I'm so anxious to see the sports administrators get involved to ensure that they encourage the population that can use these facilities to use them. And as you're using them, the talent will emerge. We have our program of the elite athletes. Once you reach a certain standard, a certain level, the Minister of Sport is always talking about it. We only seem to talk about what has not been done and what we cannot do. We don't talk about what we are doing, because the glass, for some people, even if it is three-quarter full, they will say the glass don't have enough and spend their time arguing about the missing quarter. There's a lot that is going on. Once our athletes reach a certain standard of performance, there's additional support. And that support is not minuscule. It is quite significant. And it comes from the taxpayer. So when you hear nothing happening, and there are some people who just live off the negative, let us be that cohort of the nation who know that everything has not been done. It's not perfect, but there's a lot that has been done that can be done with what we have. And if we do that, we will have a lot more pleasant days as we focus on what has to be done, if we ensure that we make the best use of what resources we have available. Thank you very much, contractor. Thank you very much, individuals and groups from the uniformed services. Thank you very much, senior officers of the Coast Guard and Defense Force, for encouraging your subordinates to use their energies here and elsewhere. Thank you very much for doing that. Thank you very much for encouraging and engendering in the community of Mova peace and security and safety for those who work here, who play here, who come here, who go from here. Encourage them to appreciate and to want that peace and security. And all of you in Mova, I look forward to you demonstrating that the time that I knew in Mova, when I used to walk from that end of the community to this end for good reason, in safety at 2 o'clock in the morning, and then we had a cinema in Mova, and the greatest thing in Mova for a young man was going to a lit show and coming out of the cinema at 3 o'clock in the morning, because that's a nice time to walk a lady home. That's what we used to do in Mova. And you sit out there and you chat, and you come out in the I walk many moonlights in this area. Today, some people are afraid to walk the streets because of the behavior of some people, albeit a minority. Let us recreate those communities. Let us recreate that kind of environment, because quality of life is not measured in dollars and cents only. It is measured in how you actually enjoy your surroundings. So enjoy this facility. I look forward to coming here sometime in the not too distant future to see your people in the pool and to enjoy the competition that will take place in this facility and others around Trinidad and Tobago. I thank you all as I release Mr. Hines from his assignment of monitoring this project, and we go on to another one somewhere else where somebody else will be monitoring it. And I also look forward to seeing the MPs in the pool demonstrating that it can be done by us and by them. Thank you very much for coming out today, and let's look forward to a very, very positive outcome to this facility for the people of Morva and surroundings. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honourable Prime Minister. I will just give a short vote of thanks. I wish to thank the Reverend Dr. Benjamin Agard, Senior Pastor, Church of the Rock, and Archbishop Wayne Jones of the St. Francis Spiritual Baptist Church for opening prayer. Thank you, Honourable Prime Minister Keith Rowley, for your feature address. Thank you, Ministers Leon, Scajo, and Hines, for your remarks and the work of your ministries. To the officers of the Coast Guard, the Police Service and Defence Force, to the Chairman, CEO, and members of staff of UDCOT, and all who made today's ceremony a reality. To our councillors and aldermen, our performers and entertainers, a hearty thank you. Ladies and gentlemen of the community and members of the media, a hearty thank you to you also. We will now have the cutting of the ribbon, and the Prime Minister and his entourage, please allow them to proceed to the area for as well the unveiling of the commemorative stone.
This is TTT. Live for local.
TTT News. Committed. Accurate. Relevant.